eat fruit and nuts and seeds.
And
the squirrels do too. And in fact, actually, if you watch, you'll see that some of the squirrels might come by while we're feeding them, because they know that the birds are getting fed, so they come and get some of the food too. The other thing that they get that we give them here is called rowdy bush. It's a pellet. It's kind of like a supplement for their diet, kind of like if you take a vitamin. Do they have vitamins in the mornings? It's kind of like that. So I'm going to walk around and tell you a little bit about each bird.
I like that color.
Oh yeah, that is Vivian. She's who I'm going to start with giving her food. Her name is Vivian. She's our only female. She's the only girl in the group. All the rest are boys. She is also our youngest bird. She is going to be 30 this year.
30.
They can live.
But
you're 4. You're 4, so she's kind of a little bit older than me. She's 30. And she's our youngest. They can live up into their 80s.
Whoa.
That's a long time, yeah. It's a big commitment. If you think of having one as a pet, you might have to pass it down to your children.
And they like trees without leaves.
They what?
They like trees without leaves.
These trees do not have leaves for them. This is our oldest bird back here. His name is Ulysses. He is going to be 39. At the beginning of May. He's a cockatoo. You find them in Australia. If you look at him, when you're watching him, you'll see he has a crest of yellow feathers on the top of his head that he can raise up or lower. This is Sarge. He and Barney are the same age. They're both 35. Were pets before they came to live with us. And for various reasons, their owners couldn't take care of them anymore, so they came to be at the zoo. So they've all been used to living with people and having people take care of them. Okay, so do you guys have any questions about the birds?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right, what's your question?
Well,
sorry.
Did Vivian or whatever her name is, did she live with people too? Or
yeah, okay. Yeah, they were all pets at one point or another.
Okay.
Does any one of them talk?
They actually, a couple of them do talk. No, we don't teach them to talk or talk ask to them to, but I think so parrots are very smart birds, and they actually, what I've read is they'll listen to people talking and then they'll practice until they feel like they've gotten something right, and then they'll say it in front of a person. So these guys will say, I've heard them say hello and goodbye and hi. Those are usually the most that I hear, which doesn't surprise me because we say hello to them every morning and every time we see them, and we usually say goodbye when we leave. So it's probably the most common words they're hearing us say as well. But they do say it, but usually it's never on command. So you have to just be walking around and hope that you'll hear it. Vivian a lot of times will say hello when a keeper comes up to feed them.
Now, why don't they fly away?
Well, they do know that their food and everything is here. They can fly. We do clip their wings that allow them to gain a lot of height and distance. So when they do fly, they fly out and kind of down. We clip the wings that would give them loft so that they don't end up in large trees the way we can't get them back.
And they always come back home.
They do, and usually they hang out in the trees because they know this is where they're going to get their food. And I don't know if you were here when I was mentioning they were all pets previously,
right,
so they kind of are used to that. So they usually hang out here, but sometimes I will come out and they'll be, you know, somewhere else.
Yeah.
Same thing with the parrots up top. They'll oftentimes get down off their trees, and you'll have to sort of go find them and move them back.
You tag them?